I want to give you 5 top tips to help you get the best out of your pop-up rigs, and we're starting right now. If you like these type of videos and you want to see some more, you may want to think about hitting that subscribe button. Don't forget to hit the bell notification icon and you'll never miss another one of these videos again. 5 top tips to get the best out of your pop-up rigs. Let's get started. Tip 1. As a starting point in any lake that I'm using pop-ups, I always like to critically balance them with the use of putty. This helps when the fish take your bait into its mouth. It flies up a lot quicker into the back of the mouth and gives you more chance for that hook to grab hold. Tip 2. Try different coloured pop-ups. If you're fishing 3 rods, try maybe a washed out pink one, a fluoro white one, and say yellow and orange, or even a food bait pop-up that you've been using. Now, the reason for this is because of different light levels and the food that's been going into the lake on any particular day, may get a bite on the washed out pink pop-up because of the light levels may be different than the day before or even earlier on in the day. Same with the white one and the food bait. It may be a dark colour if you're using a robin red fish meal or something like that. The light going through the water and the light levels on those particular days can play a big factor in which one stands out more or doesn't stand out more that the fish is going to pick up before one of the others. So that's why initially on a lake that I'm fishing, I fish 3 different coloured pop-ups to see what works on the day, and then if I'm getting bites on a prolific water, I'll swap all 3 over to the same coloured pop-up. Tip 3. As a good starting point, I normally fish a pop-up about 2 to 3 inches above the deck. If it's a lake where a lot of people are using pop-ups and the fish are getting very wary to them, I like to change the height of my pop-up. I might only have a 1-inch pop-up or a 2-inch pop-up, or I've caught on 4-inch pop-ups as well before. So changing the height, depending on the time of year and how the fish react to pop-ups on your lake, can put extra fish on the bank for you. Tip 4. This may seem pretty obvious, but you want to use the most buoyant pop-up that you can. Reason being, some of the different pop-up rigs around, like the Ronnie rig or the Hinge Stiffy, you need to use a buoyant pop-up that will stay buoyant for the lifetime of however long you've got that pop-up rig in the water. Now, it's no good, if you can imagine, you're fishing a 24-hour session, you get down in the afternoon or just before dark, you bang out your pop-ups and you reel them in the morning, you haven't had any bites, you test them in the margin and they're sinking. Make sure, and it's something which is really overlooked by a lot of anglers, make sure that pop-ups actually pop up for a long period of time, and to make sure those pop-up rigs are working effectively for the duration of your stay. Tip 5. Probably my most favourite tip is to use an overshotted pop-up. Now, I know tip 1 was to critically balance your pop-up so it goes flies back into the mouth, but if everybody's doing that, then you have to be different. I've always found that being different, whether it's your bait or your rigs or whatever you're doing on a lake, whether you're fishing 1-ounce leads instead of everyone fishing 3-ounce leads, try being different with your pop-ups. Overshot them so they're bang on the bottom. And this sometimes, if the fish are used to picking up a quickly balanced pop-up, can put more fish on the bank for you because they just haven't seen it and it just trips them up. There you go, there's 5 of my top tips to get the best out of your pop-up rigs. Don't forget, if you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button, hit that notification bell, and I'll see you for the next video.